Ni no Kuni is a movie based off of the video games by Level 5. Also, it looks like a Ghibli film because the Ni no Kuni games were also produced by Studio Ghibli. So, and they also did the cutscenes for that game. I don't know about the sequel. But this movie is about Yu. He is in a wheelchair. And he is very smart. And he's in love with his best friend's girl. And his best friend is... he's a very athletic young man. And one day, they are going to get in a car accident. And the near-death experience... makes them transport to a magical world because their friend got stabbed and they chase the guy and they find themselves in the world of Evermore, and they you can walk, and they're confused by this whole, they think it's a dream, and they're trying to find out what's going on. Ni no Kuni the movie is the most generic film I've ever seen. It does have that fantasy like setting, but the plot, the characters, literally every aspect of this movie is so, like, generic. It's, like, so standard. You know, you can guess the villain literally in the first half hour of the movie. Any of the twists get debunked immediately. Even the finale just feels paint by numbers. Literally every single thing about this movie is just taken from the trope playbook. You know, you got the villain, and the villain turns into a monster. And then he's like, ha, 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 you thought you could kill me, but you can't. And it's just a very pedestrian, that's the word I'm looking for, a very pedestrian plot, pace, characters, everything about this movie is so pedestrian. There's one thing I did like about the movie. The two sword fight sequences are really dynamic and well directed. Other than that, though, yeah, the movie is just so... robotic and mechanical. It's just, you know, the two boys, they got to go on this adventure, save the princess, defeat the person villain. It didn't try to surprise you in any way. I was hoping they would. At the end there, I was thinking, what if that other guy was the villain? And he wasn't, because that would be, you know, interesting. So overall, Ni no Kuni, you know, has decent animation, I guess, and those dynamic sword fights are cool, but I can't recommend this movie. It's just too generic. So I give Ni no Kuni a 2 out of 10.